There is no holy grail in trading, but a diversified portfolio comes pretty close. With a correlation matrix, you can quantify the level of diversification your portfolio offers. Here's how you can do it with free software.
Correlation is the degree to which two datasets move in the same direction. Developed by Carl Pearson, the Pearson correlation coefficient measures correlation and ranges from minus 1 to plus 1. These two curves are perfectly correlated and produce a coefficient of plus 1 because they rise or fall together, though not necessarily at the same rate. Conversely, these curves are negatively correlated and produce a coefficient of minus 1 because when one rises, the other falls. For coefficient values close to 0, the datasets are uncorrelated and move independently. The Pearson coefficient looks complicated, but you can easily compute it in Excel with the correl function. So what are these datasets made of? Traditionally, analysts have measured the correlation between asset prices. In Forex, one of the most persistent correlations is the inverse relationship between the euro-dollar and dollar-franc due to the strong ties between the eurozone and Switzerland. If you want a good reference on correlations between Forex markets, check out monaf.net, where you can find the correlations between many Forex markets over different timeframes. If you do long-only investing or trade an identical strategy across many markets, measuring correlations between price series is a sensible idea. But what if you trade a variety of trend-following and mean reversion strategies or hold both long and short positions at the same time? For such situations, it's more pertinent to quantify the correlation between your strategy's equity curves. Let me illustrate with two very different strategies. The first is a pound-yen trend-following strategy that I developed using StrategyQuant's genetic algorithm. Check out the video at the top right to learn more about StrategyQuant's automatic strategy generation. Let's backtest the strategy from 2008 to 2019 and save the report. The second strategy is a mean reversion strategy that trades the pound Canadian. Now open QuantAnalyzer and open the two backtest reports. Having a look at the individual strategy equity curves, you can see that the trend strategy tends to have the occasional large winner, accompanied by many small losses in between. On the other hand, the mean reversion strategy has many small winners, punctuated by the occasional large loss. You can probably infer that the strategy correlations should be low in this case, but let's find out. Select both strategies and create portfolio, which will appear under the Portfolios tab. Head over to the Portfolio Correlation tab. First, you have to select the equity curve sampling interval. If you're a day trader, daily sampling makes sense. For swing trading, try weekly sampling. Use monthly for anything longer term. I'll pick weekly. Select correlation of profit and loss. I usually check allow negative correlation. This affects only the appearance of the correlation matrix, which we will check later. If you leave allow negative correlation unchecked, large negative correlations will be colored red. Generally, you don't want your correlations to be too negative since your strategy's performance would cancel out. When you compare strategies that were developed over different historical periods, there will be periods when one or more strategies has zero trades. If you check add empty periods, a zero correlation value will be assigned to the period with no trades. If unchecked, these empty periods will be ignored. Since both strategies are backtested over the same 12-year period, this option is not relevant. Click Compute, and there's your matrix. The minus 0.03 values indicates the strategies are practically uncorrelated. That's good news, but why is that important? To see why uncorrelated strategies are important, let's compare the performance metrics of each individual strategy to those of the overall portfolio. I'll focus on the return over maximum drawdown, a simple risk-adjusted metric, and the stagnation in days, which is the amount of time needed to reach a new equity high. Compared to each strategy in isolation, the overall portfolio exhibits a higher return over drawdown and a considerably shorter stagnation, smoothening out the overall portfolio equity curve. The reason for this is your strategy returns are additive, but the drawdowns are not. The caveat is that your strategies have to be uncorrelated, meaning they experience drawdowns at different periods. So what's the highest correlation coefficient you should accept between strategies in your portfolio? In general, I consider 0.4 to indicate significant correlation, while 0.7 indicates very strong correlation. Ideally, all your inter-strategy correlations should be below 0.4. Of course, it's not always easy to churn out a bunch of high-performing, uncorrelated strategies. If you have a large portfolio, having a couple strategies with correlations in the 0.5 to 0.6 range is unlikely to be a problem. The decision is yours to make. Another option is to attach more weight to the strategies that are lowly correlated with the others in your portfolio, and vice versa for those with high correlations. So the next time you're thinking of adding a strategy to your portfolio, be sure to check out its correlations first. In general, the more uncorrelated strategies you trade, the better your overall portfolio performance will be, as long as you have sufficient capital. If you want to construct your correlation matrix, you can do so using QuantAnalyzer's free version. To unlock its full functionality, check out the discount code in the description. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. If you want to supercharge your portfolio trading by automating your strategy, check out the step-by-step guide at the top right. To learn the ins and outs of building a portfolio using QuantAnalyzer's Portfolio Master, check the guide at the bottom.